course, this is not my first trip to Chicago. I've come here many times. Actually, it's pronounced Chicago, which is Algonquin for Cubs win, Cubs win. You know, some of the funny things that happened in the movie, I was expecting just to do the song when I got there. And Michael comes to me and he says, well, you're an actor. He says, can you handle a few lines? I went, sure. He handed me 8 pages of dialogue. And I said, when are we shooting this? And he goes, oh, 20 minutes. So I learned about maybe 5 lines in the whole thing. And Dana and Mike did the whole we're not worthy thing. And I had to find a spot between them to do the deliver the lines. And I was making half of it up as I was going along because I wasn't going to do it more than one time. I was going to do this one time. And they did everything they could to make me laugh. They did every character they could to make me laugh. And I focused on that one line. I did it in 2 takes. Thank you very much.
Very good.
But
all right.
If you would have seen the outtakes of the We're Not Worthy, it went on for about 10 minutes and it got vile. It was vile. I mean, if they ever show those outtakes, they'll leave their careers and go on.
How, your appearance in the film, how did it change your life?
Well, you know, first of all, it introduced us to a new audience. And I figured this was going to be the closest thing I ever got to Saturday Night Live. So, and I watched the bit before and I thought it was very funny. Because we know so many guys just like that. In fact, Garth is identical to Glenn Buxton, who was in our band, who was our lead player, that passed away, but he was identical on every level of that of Garth. I thought that they fashioned him after Glenn, our guitar player. So, I mean, it was, you know, the great thing about the movie was it made more money than Batman. Because it didn't cost anything to make. And Batman cost a fortune, so Wayne's World actually made more money than that, and had more catchphrases in it, I think.
Right, you know, I was being somewhat facetious. I wasn't, actually. I was being honestly truthful. It is a very influential film. So much came out of that movie. That
Michael Myers was at his best in that movie, I think. And when you meet Michael, you meet all of his characters first. Yeah, I took me about 6 times meeting Michael before I actually met Mike, you know. And same with Dana. They each, you know, they have all these characters out here, and you have to get through them to finally get to the guy. Both of them are great, great.
Like you.
That'd be too funny. I wish they would have made 10 more Wayne's Worlds, you know. Then you know how that goes. You never know. Some people ask me all the time, they say, which Wayne's World were you in? I said, the funny one.
But you're in Chicago for more than the film tonight. You're playing tomorrow night, right?
Tinley Park tomorrow night. Purple,
right? Frankenstein.
And we do the full-out Alice Cooper show, so I mean, it's like we take no prisoners. If you're going to be there, it's the full-out show. Be ready for Halloween tomorrow night.
And you recently released a new album?
Yes, Paranormal is out right now, and it's in the top 10 in 20 countries right now, which is great for this late in the game. You know,
right?
It just means rock and roll is here to stay. It's not going anywhere.
Right. And it shows that people who like rock and roll buy records, which is a great thing.
That's right. Record sales last year, albums, if you have record players, keep them. Because album sales went up 85% last year. I think kids are getting tired of buying hair. They actually get an album and they get to look at it and they get the ritual of putting it on the turntable and letting it play. That is a great ritual. I think it's coming back.
All right. Hope so.
It sounds good. Analog sounds good.
Well, we can't thank you enough for doing this tonight.
Thank you very much. This.
Yeah.
And,
there
you go.
I love you, Alex!
I love you. I really don't love you. Thank you, everybody. And enjoy the movie. I am shocked that I didn't get an Academy Award for this.
I mean, Al Pacino. All right, it's showtime.